Hi, I'm Chris from Fibre, Glast. Today we're going to show you our number 590 vacuum infusion trial kit that we carry on fiberglast.com. If you haven't done so already, be sure to check out our Learning Center article titled The Equipment and Process of Resin Infusion. The article will help you attain a basic understanding of vacuum infusion equipment and processes. If you're comfortable with vacuum bagging composite parts, our vacuum infusion trial kit offers everything you need to get familiar with the vacuum infusion process. You just need to have your laminate components, a vacuum source, vacuum tubing, and vacuum bagging materials. The 590 vacuum infusion trial kit comes with enough materials to build three practice laminates that can be up to 24 by 13 inches. We selected the components of this kit to give you experience with three types of flow media. EnkaFusion Nylon Infusion Media is one of our mesh-style flow media options. Lantor Soric XF is a conformable fabric-style flow media. Divinymat is a grooved, perforated, and scored vinyl foam structural flow media. After experimenting with each style of flow media, feel free to check out our website to learn more about the different options we offer for a given style. It's important to remember that before you can get started with the vacuum infusion process, you must have already completed and prepared your mold properly, selected your resin, reinforcement, and vacuum bagging materials. The different styles of flow media impact the final laminate differently. Mesh or matte styles do not provide additional bulk or any significant strength advantages. They are primarily chosen due to their superior infusion times. Fabric flow medias such as Lantor Soric add bulk and assist in the infusion process, but, like the mesh and matte flow media, do not offer significant strength. Divinymat sandwich core assists with the infusion process while also adding bulk, strength, and rigidity. To set up your resin supply line, you will use EnkaFusion filter jacket and a plastic T fitting. First, place a long strip of the filter jacket with peel ply beneath it along the edge of the laminate where the resin will be supplied. Then, cut a slit in a shorter piece of filter jacket, passing one end of the T-fitting through the slit and placing the short piece of filter jacket and T-fitting atop the larger strip. Resin will flow into the T-fitting, pass through the filter jacket, and quickly spread through the width of the filter jacket while also flowing across the laminate toward the vacuum source. To set up your vacuum feed line, use your half-inch spiral tubing. Wrap the spiral tubing in peel ply to make sure flow isn't inhibited. Place the T-fitting in line and arrange the tubing within the bag so that air and resin can be drawn through the entire length of tubing from your resin supply. Make and seal an opening for the T-fitting to pass through the bag. Attach the half-inch vacuum tubing to the fitting and your vacuum source. When your in-bag resin and vacuum lines are complete, set up your resin bucket with the supplied resin line holder. Then, crimp your feed line with the supplied flow regulator, perform your leak checks, and catalyze your resin. Next, you can remove the flow regulator and allow resin to be infused into your part. After you've used your 590 vacuum infusion trial kit to experiment with the infusion process, you can try various setups, using spiral tubing with your resin supply, using alternative flow media options, or setting up multiple resin feed ports for a single laminate. We hope this video and our 590 vacuum infusion trial kit have helped you understand the vacuum infusion process and can help you make a decision about what flow media will work best for your project. Thanks for watching Fiberglast on YouTube. Remember to check out our number 590 and all of our other resin infusion supplies on fiberglast.com. Take a moment to subscribe to our channel and like this video.